What's up, everyone? This is one of the craziest and most expensive podcast setups that I've ever built. Let's check it out. Point them down for an overhead shot if we want to do something like that. But that is the range that these cameras can move. All right, so we are rocking a 10 camera podcast setup right now. We have four right here shooting the desks. Right now it's set up for two people to talk, but we could easily fit in more tables, push things forward or backwards. We do have a lot of space to work with, so that's really nice. This podcast setup is actually in the middle of an event space. So we have more cameras around the podcast setup. And that way we can not only shoot the stage, but transition easily from podcast to stage and back and forth. Everything's run from the same tech world over in the back corner here. So that means all of our cables we ran in the ceiling. We have a harness going down, up, and all the way back to tech world. And with that, a big part of the podcast setup was making sure you didn't see cables. We didn't want cables running all over the floor, so as much as we could hide it, we did. What you're looking at behind me, besides the four cameras, we do have four of the Elgato key lights. Again, nothing crazy. We didn't try to overdo it. It is enough light to do what we need to do here. And we have these 55-inch curved TVs, three of them. The cool thing is they're actually on these up desk legs. Basically, this is just half of an up desk, the frame on the ground holding up the stand. Then this is mounted upside down, and then I built these little mounts to drill into a TV mount, and that's how it holds the TV. And then again, from Elgato, we got these little monitor clips that can clip onto a TV. I did have to rig them up a little bit, but they, between that and some industrial Velcro, is what holds up the lights. So that's the back here. One thing I will note is that we have a small speaker right here on this stand. The speaker does one thing. It is meant so a Zoom participant can talk to the talent. So if I'm the talent in this case, I'm looking at the TVs. I can see not only a multi-view, but my laptop screen, but people on Zoom. And the speaker is so the sound comes from there versus our large 15-inch JBLs in the room. But that little speaker doesn't get picked up by this microphone, and that's the purpose of it. That way we don't have to wear headphones. We're constantly moving around. We do have a lot of wireless running in here if we want to run in-ear monitors, plug headphones directly into the Rodecaster. This podcast setup is built for multi-purpose. We can run it through the system. We can run a Zoom call off this laptop. We can run a Zoom call from up on stage. Wherever we want to be, that's what the system's built for. So on the desk setup here, we have a Rodecaster Pro 2. We have an A10 Mini, and these guys are for the mics on the tables, and the A10 Mini is actually taking all of the camera feeds from the 8K Constellation switcher we have in the back. A single program feed is coming up, and this is working as a capture card to convert the HDMI signal into a webcam so it can go into the computer. This means the client can come and sit down, pop open a Zoom call on their laptop, and get the entire studio running into their Zoom call as their webcam. Get clean audio from here, and we do have not only cameras here, but we have, we call them God cams. They hang from the ceiling. They're up there. They are PTZs, Blackmagic Studio cameras rigged to a Ronin rig on an up desk. It's actually two legs together, and they move up and down in unison, so it can go all the way up to the ceiling or come 6 to 7 feet off the ground. This way, no tripods on the ground. We can drive cars underneath. It is really, really useful. We like them a lot. And we also have a camera above the video wall shooting this way, so you can kind of see the shot that you're looking at now and what we're looking at. And then we have our stage cameras as well, shooting from the side, our tight shots. So all those cameras get routed into this A10 Mini, and then we have a stream deck here that runs the entire show. These buttons here on the side route different cameras, laptop feeds to the live stream, to that A10 mini. It goes into our Zoom call, it goes to our stream, wherever it wants to go. That's what these blue buttons are for. These ones in the middle here are to route things to the video wall. So it's unlikely we would ever route a camera to the video wall, but we would route a laptop feed, multiple computers at one time, maybe a Zoom participant, whatever we want to route to the video wall, we can do that here. And then we have these are our control functions, so we can change what's happening on the monitors in front of us, as well as auto-focusing the cameras when we sit down, gaining them up and down, etc. We're not trying to complicate it by having multiple pages. Again, one page, these are the buttons you get. We can easily add or subtract per show. But for now, this is what we're rocking with, and it's been working really well. All right, and this is what the podcast camera looks like. So this is just one of the shots. We do have a lot of different angles here, and I can see when we go from a wide shot to, let's say, a tight shot, which camera to look at based on the tally lights. This shot here is just so we can take a look at something that's happening up on the video wall. So if I wanted to route my laptop to the video wall, I could click one button, and now my laptop is showing, and we could look at a video together with my guest, if I had one here. And I could also go over to their camera and check out them while they're talking. And I've said this in some previous videos, but if you do not have an Apple TV wired into your studio, you really need one. A lot of times we are casting from a phone up to our video wall here. And it's the ability to show off other things that are happening in the space, or even go into selfie mode and route that directly into our live stream. So I could walk around the room with my wireless camera and it still looks pretty good. We don't have a whole bunch of antennas or other things happening. It's just this camera. So that's just one way to use the Apple TV. Obviously you can cast your laptop and other phones to the video wall wirelessly, which helps a lot when we're doing a demo or just want to show someone something quickly up on the video wall.
And so now I am in tech world. This is where the person controlling the whole show will sit. He can monitor audio, he can change different camera angles, he can have multiple computers for different things. This computer over here normally runs what is a Zoom call with virtual participants, and we have two displays running through the switcher so we can full screen a face or multiple faces, have a screen share, and route those to different locations so we can get them nice and clean, full 1080p. In the middle, we have a couple monitors. This one in the middle is our main multi-view, and this one at top can actually change between different looks depending on what we want to full screen at any time. So up top, we have the program feed, what's being routed to our live stream. But I usually like to cut on the preview bus and then either do a cut or a dissolve over to the next shot. That's the way that I like to switch. The 1ME advanced panel, we use the second ME to run the video wall. So if I wanted to pull up, let's say, the Apple TV and I could fade that onto the video wall, we can see how that would change here. Again, it is key that we can control every little detail from back here, including our God cam. So we have cameras that not only have servo lenses, but we can actually move them up and down and point them wherever we want. So I have buttons back here that allow me to bring a camera either up or down, and we can move just one or both of them at the same time. And with the Ronin app, we're not using middle things, but we definitely could. It is a great product. But with the Ronin app, we are able to control where these point, get them all the way to the ceiling and point them down for an overhead shot if we want to do something like that. But that is the range that these cameras can move. Really helpful. They're nice and stable. The stabilization of the gimbal is also helping a lot if we do run into any sort of shakiness. So if you have other questions about that, be sure to go check out that other video that is all about the tech here. Main talent would sit here. You'd be the guest right now, and we could have a conversation, record it all, stream it in real time, ISO record it for later and have an editor chop it up. Whatever we want to do, we can do it from here. Hope you guys like the setup. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out in the comments, and hopefully you got an idea or two for your own setup. Thanks for watching.